Toyota Tacoma Hidden Gems. These are features that you either forgot about or never even knew you had. Good evening, everybody, and welcome back to Rob Motive. Today, we're going to take a look at some Toyota Tacoma hidden gems, some hidden features that you may not have even known that you have. You know, one of these I actually just discovered myself today. But we're going to start in the back. These are just little helpful things, from noise reduction to placement of things, to make your Toyota Tacoma experience a little bit more enjoyable. So let's head to the back seat. I'm gonna show you the first one. Okay, for this first one, we actually have to be in the back seat. This is a way to stow away the seat belt little clips, you know, the ends that you plug into when you're not using them. Instead of them falling in behind the seats or people can't find them, there are actually little grooves here or little pockets to put these things in. They're on each side. There's one here, and one here. Now, this is handy because you can take the seatbelt end, if you will, and this is easier to do if you go ahead and pop the seat up, but I can't really lay in here while I'm doing that. So, you just kind of push it up like that, gets the seatbelt out of the way. When you pull this up and down, and I'll show you that in just a second, it's not gonna fall down behind the seat. Love these things, and if you never looked, you'd never even know they were there. You can do the same thing with the one in the center here. I already have it pushed up in there a little bit. Just kind of slides in right there. And then the one over here on the driver's side, rear, you do the same thing. You just stick them right up inside these little pockets and it keeps them from going underneath when you pull the seats up, like this. Now they're not gonna fall down here and people aren't gonna be able to find them or jump in the truck and then have to get out, especially if it's pouring down rain or anything crazy. All they have to do is reach down here and pull it out, and then there is their little seat belt in. Pretty cool little place to store them, keeps them out of the way, even gives you a nice little sleeker kind of look back here with everything kind of hidden away. One of these little things that if you never noticed, you might not have even known that you had these things. Pretty cool. Next up is the seat pull, or the absence of the seat pull. If you have an older Toyota Tacoma, you may still have this, or you may have seen it and remember, but there used to be a pull right down here that you could grab a hold of to pull the seat up. Very similar to this. But for some reason, I guess money savings, Toyota decided to remove the seat pull. So now when you want to pull the seat up, and I always forget, you just grab here on the edge and lift it up. But you don't have to do that. You see, where it used to be was right here. This is a threaded hole that you can put a bolt in and bolt a pull to it, if you will. And I did this on my other truck. You may not even be aware this is there. What I did on the other truck is I just bought, because it was a blue theme, a blue bungee cord. And then I cut off a section, folded it over like so, and then put a little holder down here, or a little clasp, if you will, to kind of put it together. And that's how I made my handle. And then I just put the screw or the bolt in there, right in that hole, and put it up over the top so it looks something like this. So there was a pull there that I could grab, and because it's a bungee, it was stretchy too, so it kind of gave a little bit when I pulled on it. I really like that. It worked really well, and I am going to do that on this truck. I'll probably do it in orange so it matches my orange theme in here, but it worked really well. I really liked it, and why Toyota got rid of that, I still to this day have no idea, but I guess if you sell, I don't know, 200,000, pick a number, whatever, trucks, and the two of these, because there was one on each side, cost a buck a piece, let's say, well, you know, that's $200,000 back to your bottom line by simply removing this. So I know why Toyota did it, But come on, it's pretty petty, right? So that's another little hidden gem that you may not know about, a little feature in that we have this little screw hole here that you can put a bolt on and mount your own seat pole if you want in the back. The next one, number three, has to do with visibility through the rear view mirror. You know, when you're sitting in the back and you're trying to look out of the window, and you know, the Tacoma doesn't have a really huge window in the back to see out of anyway, and it gets even worse when you have the headrests blocking your view in the way. Now, you can see over there, I have this one kind of folded down. Now, I wasn't aware of this when I first got the truck. I think I actually discovered it in a video somewhere. You have two choices. You could just remove it, and it could be stowed in the back somewhere, probably, let's say, behind the seats, because they do fold forward, of course, and I'm assuming you know that. But you don't have to do that, because they fold down just like that one does, and it's pretty easy. There's a little knob, button, whatever here on the side that you push, of course, to raise and lower the rear headrest. You just push that in, and then with one hand, like so, it just folds forward. Now, that is pretty darn easy. I don't know how it could be any easier than that. And it's just a good way to be able to stow these without actually removing them, which you can do, by the way. They just pull up. If you want to remove them, you just push in on the sides and then they come out. There's one little knob here, hard to do with one hand. But if you push both in with two hands, this will come out all together, and then you can stow it, like I said, somewhere behind the seats. Obviously, if you pull the seat forward, there's plenty of room back there to stow them in this black void you guys see. But I prefer to just keep them folded down like so, so that if I have a passenger in the rear or something, they can just flip it back, it goes down, and then they're golden and ready to go. Just another little hidden feature that you may not have known about. Next up, a way to eliminate the flap. You have the seat belt back here, and of course, if you have your window down, it bounces around, it makes noise, and if you're noise sensitive, probably gonna drive you nuts. You may even wonder, what is that scraping back there, right? Well, there is a handy little feature. Let's go ahead and pull the seat down a little bit, that Toyota included, and kudos to them for at least leaving this in the truck and not removing it like they did the seat poles. And that's this little clip right here. You may or may not have noticed this. It's kind of hidden if you're not looking for it, but the way it works, pretty simple, you just slip your seatbelt right behind it, and it's gonna help cut down on that noise, this thing bouncing around like crazy. You can see here, I mean, it can still move a little bit, but it's not gonna flap around, you know, like this, if you don't have it in there. And if you're like me and you don't have a lot of people riding in the back, which I rarely do, this is probably going to stay there permanently and never move anyway. Another little bonus thing, while I'm back here, you do have a couple of clips. I believe there's one on the other side. This is behind the passenger seat, where you can hang little bags for groceries and stuff. Little neat handy feature that you may not have noticed. This next one, and this is number five, I actually just discovered this today. It has to do with the hood, and you can see on my hood, I have hood struts that I just installed recently. There is a video on the channel about that. These are no drill hood struts. Love these, love the fact that you don't have to drill anything to put them in. One thing that worried me about the other brand out there is drilling up through the hood. Pretty risky if you go too far. But I was driving around and I noticed there are some noises coming from the truck, right? So I've been trying to figure out what these are. So I'm under the hood, let me point you down. I'll show you what I discovered today and how you can eliminate it. What I'm talking about is the rod that you don't need anymore. It moves around quite a bit in there. And you can imagine when you go over bumps, that can get kind of loud, right? So there is a way to remove this without any tools or anything. And it's over here on the edge. Let me see if I can get you a good angle there. Right over on the edge where it actually goes in, right here in the side, there's a little round hole. Now, all you have to do is kind of manipulate this thing forward. So it's down like this, bring it out, and then just pull it forward gently towards the front of the truck. And it just pulls right out. very, very simple. It's just a little hook thing that kind of fits in there. Then you're not gonna have the noise of this thing bouncing around. So if you're sensitive to noises in the truck and you think, man, what is that rattling sound I hear all the time coming from the front? Especially when you go over bumps, if you drive on any kind of rough roads or anything. Well, this is probably it. This thing bouncing around inside your engine bay. So it can be removed, you can stow it somewhere. And of course, I'm talking about if you have hood struts like I do. Obviously, if you don't have hood struts and you're under your hood often and you need to use this, well, then you wouldn't want to take it out. I mean, you could. You could throw it in the back seat and, or maybe behind the back seats, and then go ahead and stick it back in there when you need to, since it's so simple to do. But either way, it will alleviate any kind of noises that you might have. And I was quite surprised when I messed with this morning, because again, I'm trying to figure out, what is all the rattling coming from the front of my truck? It's this thing. Those are five Toyota Tacoma hidden gems or features that you may not have known about. Just simple little things that you can do. None of it costs any money. Well, I guess except maybe buying some kind of a bungee cord or something for that extra strap or missing straps in the back. But otherwise, these are things that you can utilize just to make the Toyota Tacoma experience a little bit better. Leave a comment. Let me know. Did you know about these things? I'd be curious to know. And if there's anything else I missed, please leave a comment and let me know. Also, real quick, I do have two additional channels. Rob Motive FST, all about my 2021 Toyota Tundra. And Rob Motive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. Check them out, and if you're interested, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.